اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today, inshallah, we're going to reflect upon the reality of the tongue and the effects of the tongue and the significant role that it plays in our faith and in our iman. In a beautiful hadith reported by Imam al-Tirmidhi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, on the authority of Sayyidina Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, who says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا أَصْبَحَ إِبْنُ آدَمْ, when the human being rises in the morning. And this is a reality. Every single morning, what is going to follow in conversation actually occurs. إِذَا أَصْبَحَ إِبْنُ آدَمْ. So, when morning comes, every single morning, the human being, this is what's going to happen. فَإِنَّ الْأَعْضَاءَ كُلُّهَا تُكَفِّرُ اللِّسَانِ. All of the limbs of your body will humble themselves before the tongue. And what will they do? تقول اتقي الله فينا. All the limbs will say in your body, fear Allah by us. Fear Allah through us. And that's a conversation that occurs between the bodily parts and the tongue in our body. فإنما نحن بك. And so the body parts say to the tongue, we are by you. Meaning, whatever you do, we are actually going to bear the consequence. فَإِنَّمَا نَحْنُ بِكَ. We are through you. فَإِنِ اسْتَقَمْتَ اسْتَقَمْنَا. And so the parts of the body, of your body, of my body, say, if you are upright, if you are steadfast, if you take care of yourself and say the right thing, فَإِنِ اسْتَقَمْتَ اسْتَقَمْنَا, then we will be steadfast and we will be upright. وَإِنِ اعْوَجَجْتَ اعْوَجَجْنَا. And if you swerve from the straight path, then we will also swerve from guidance. In this beautiful hadith, a reality is exposed to us that happens every single day, and highlighting the significance of the role of the tongue. It's said that the tongue is the interpreter of the heart, al-lisanu turjamanu al-qalb. And the human being is by the two small organs in the body, and they are the tongue and the heart. The heart being the sultan, the ruler, the asl, the foundation, and the tongue being its deputy in the outward realm of this physical existence. And so whatever dwells in the heart of belief, of characteristics, of spiritual states will eventually manifest on the tongue, whether you like it or not. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam explains to us, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليصمت وفي رواية أو فليسكت. A person who believes in Allah and the last day, then let him or her be silent, remain silent. من صمت نجا. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, a person who is silent gains salvation and protection. There are times when we need to be silent, whilst there are times that we need to speak. Human beings generally will regret words that they have spoken, words that you and I have spoken. We can't take those back. We can say sorry, we can seek forgiveness from the person for upsetting them, but we can't remove it. We can't take it away. We can't change history. It's like a nail when you hammer it into the fence post. It's in there, but if you've nailed it in the wrong place, you take it out, but the mark is still there. And so every single word that you utter, the effect will remain, even though you try and fix it up and cover it up and seek forgiveness if it's wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, it is easier in the sight of Allah for the Kaaba to be torn down brick by brick than for a Muslim to insult his fellow Muslim, for a believer to insult his or her fellow believer. And how does insult happen? Well, it's either going to happen through the gestures of the body or the words on the tongue, our speech. And so therefore, we take heed of the saying of Allah in the Quran, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا, and speak well to all people. It's not just to people that agree with you. It's not just to people that follow your religion, your deen of Islam, but it's to all people. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. And say beautiful words to people. If we want to know what the definition of a Muslim is, that's pretty handy, isn't it? Because if we profess Islam, we profess Iman, faith and submission to Allah, then it makes sense to know whether we're actually doing what is required of the basic definition of a Muslim. Well, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, al-Muslim, al-Muslim, the Muslim, the true Muslim, al-Muslimu man salim al-hu, nasu min yadihi wa lisanihi, or min lisanihi wa yadihi. A true Muslim is the one who all people, man salima an-nasu min lisanihi wa yadihi. A true Muslim is the one who all people are safe from his or her tongue and his or her hand. So if you can prevent harm from your tongue to be issued to people, and you can prevent harm from your hands to be made upon people, don't hurt them. Don't take something without right. Do not insult them. Do not upset them. Do not say something that is a lie, that is backbiting, that is spreading tales that are untrue, that even if it were true and you knew that if this person were to be present in your gathering, they wouldn't be happy with what you were saying. So it's called ghibah, right? It is backbiting. And this is something that is disliked, detestable, prohibited in the sight of Allah, exalted be He. And so therefore we come back to our tongue in this month of Ramadan, when we do siyam, when we fast from food and drink, let us also fast from ill speech. Let us also fast from and abstain from speech that is not going to gain us nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in another beautiful hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us on the authority of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, لَا تُكْثِرُ الْكَلَامَ بِغَيْرِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Do not indulge in excessive talk without remembering Allah, except that you remember Allah. So none of this talk, and conversation, and exchanging speech, but there's no mention of Allah. And so this must be part and parcel of every single conversation that we have, that as a bare minimum, we begin it with the mention of Allah. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah, wa bismillah, and we end it likewise. So, لَا تُكْثِرُ الْكَلَامَ بِغَيْرِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Do not indulge in excessive talk without the dhikr, the remembrance of Allah. فَإِنَّ كَثْرَةَ الْكَلَامِ بِغَيْرِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى قَصْوَةُ الْقَلْبِ. What happens when we indulge in excessive conversation that is missing dhikrullah? It's missing remembrance of Allah. The consequence is unfortunate. The true reality is that we are going to earn for ourselves a hardened heart, قَصْوَةُ الْقَلْبِ. And the last thing that we want on earth is a heart that is hardened, a heart that is as hard as stone and rock. Because the problem with that type of spiritual heart is no amount of light is going to be able to penetrate. No amount of guidance is going to be able to benefit. No amount of reminder is going to allow that person to take heed of the proper path and to listen to that nasiha and advice. Sayyidina Abu Bakr used to place a stone in his mouth. Why? In order to ensure that he would only be conscious and aware when he spoke. And he would point to his tongue and he would say, this is the organ, this is the reason that caused me to do that which I do of wrong, or to earn those negative consequences. Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an would look at a bird and he would say, oh, I wish I was that bird perched on the tree. But this is the one who, if the iman and faith of the entire ummah were on one side of the scale and his iman on the other, his would outweigh the entire ummah. But he was still someone who had this understanding and concept of fear of Allah and realizing the importance of taking care of the lisan, of the tongue. So let us allow our coming days and nights to be nights in which we abstain from excessive talk without dhikrullah. and we ensure that we don't mention anyone in a way that is insulting or upsetting or an act of backbiting or talebearing or creating lies about people or causing friction and conflict in families, between couples, between friends, but rather let our speech be speech which brings people together. And don't allow whatever comes to your tongue ready to be spoken, but pause for a minute and ask yourself, would this be something that the angel on my right is going to write down of good deeds, or something that the angel on my left is going to record? You need to make that conscious decision before you ever utter any word. And that was the reality of Imam Udar al-Hijra, Sayyidina Imam Malik ibn Anas, radiallahu ta'ala an, who would say, before I utter a word, I present to the angel on my right and the angel on my left, and if it is approved, I then say it. May Allah allow us to have husnul kalam, beautiful speech. Ameen ya rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.